It's called Descending Dungeons. Holy cow. What is that number? Would you like to guess? You don't have a clue. If you want to describe a moderately large number, Brady, you describe it as writing a tower of numbers. For instance, you might write 2 to the 3 to the 4 to the 5. And that's not a very big number, but it's big enough. There are different ways to interpret it. Do you mean 2 to the 3 to the 4 to the 5? Or do you mean 2 to the 3 to the 4 to the 5, like that? So there are two different ways, parenthesizing it from the top down or from the bottom up. And if you do it from the bottom up, the tower essentially collapses. 2 cubed is 8, so we would have 8 to the 4th to the 5th. But 8 to the 4th is 2 to the 12, and to the 5th, this is 2 to the 60. So this is about 10 to the 18. It's big, but it's not very big. Now, whereas if we do it from the top down, this is the official way to do it, 4 to the 5 is 2 to the 10th, which is 1024. So we have 3 to the 1/24, 2 to that power. Now 3 to the 1024 is pretty big. So this is 2 to the 10 to the 489. And that's a pretty big number. So parenthesizing from the top down, that's the default in most computer languages. Okay, so this gives you some pretty big numbers. On the other hand, my good friend Marc Le Brun had an idea. He said, instead of having towers, let's have dungeons. Let's go down. He says, we're going to use the following notation, which actually is in common use. I'll let A sub B mean read A and base B. And we do that all the time. For instance, in binary notation, 7 is 111. So you would write 111 sub 2, which means interpret 111 in base 2 is equal to 7 in base 10. And the way you read this, you say, all right, that one is a 1, that one is a 2, and that one is a 4. So this is 4 plus 2 plus 1, which is indeed 7. So that's the notation. Now, if A had just one digit, it's kind of boring. If we took 3 sub 17, it's just 3 in 10. Single digit numbers don't change under this operation. So the first interesting number is 10. And we're going to rebase it in base 11. And we're going to rebase that in base 12. And rebase that in 13. And go for a while down to n steps and stop. What do we get? What are these numbers? Well, again, you have to decide how to parenthesize it. There are two ways, from the top or from the bottom. And in this case, parenthesizing it from the bottom up is the best. 10 sub 11, for example, just to get started. What is 10 sub 11? Well, that 1 means 11, and that 0 means you've got 0 digits, so it's 11. Okay, what about 10 sub 11 sub 12? Well, we're going to parenthesize from the bottom up. So that's 10. Now, 11's rebased to base 12. That 1 means 12, and that 1 means 1. So 12 plus 1 is 13. So that's 10 sub 13. Now, 10 sub 13, that 1 means 13, and that 0 means you don't have any more digits to add. Okay, now what about 10 sub 11 sub 12 sub 13? And again, we put in the parens. Well, so it's 10 sub 11. 12 sub 13, what's that? That 1 is 13 plus 2. Dollars is 15, so that's 11 sub 15. But now, what is 11 sub 15? Well, that one is a 15, is worth $15, that one is worth $1, so that's 16. And 10 sub 16 is 16. So the sequence that we're getting starts with 10, and then we get 11, 13, and 16. All right, let's do another one. So 10 sub 11, 12, 13, 14. 13 sub 14 is 14 plus 3, it's 17. Okay. 12 sub 17 is 17 plus 2 is 19. Now we have 11 sub 19. 11 sub 19, that one is 19, that one makes 20. So that's 20, and then we have 10 sub 20, which is equal to 20. So the next term in the sequence is 20. And we keep going. And the question is, how big do these numbers grow? Well, we could also have parenthesized it. Let me show you what it looks like if we do it the other way around, from top down, 10. Then we have 10 sub 11. Well, that's 11 again. Now we have 10 sub 11 sub 12, but I'm going to put the parentheses around the top two. So 10 sub 11 is 11. 11 sub 12 is 13 again, same as it was here. 10 sub 11 sub 12 sub 13 with parens like this. So this is equal to 11 sub 12, which is 13 sub 13. That one means $13. That three means three single dollars, so we get 16. Well, that's what we got before. But soon it's going to change. If we parenthesize these dungeons from the bottom up, we get one sequence. 10, 11, 13, 16, 20, and then the next one is 25. After 25, we get 31, 38, and 46, and so on. And then it slowly increases, as you can see, and after a while, it starts to get bigger and bigger and bigger. And after we've gone to 100 or so steps, we're starting to get some pretty big numbers. Whereas, on the other hand, if we parenthesize from the top down, we get much, much bigger numbers very quickly. From the top down, it grows really quickly. Yeah, okay, we get the sequence 10, 11, 13, 20. So far it agrees, but then we get 30, 48, 76, 132, 420, and so on. And after a mere 30 steps, we're getting gigantic numbers, as you can see here.
Good.
So that's the second sequence.
Where are you taking us next?
Well, I want to give you two more, which is the other way, natural way to make a dungeon. If you give me a bit of paper, I'll show you. In this sequence, we're going to start with 10, and then we'll do 11 sub 10, 12 sub 11 sub 10, 13 sub 12 sub 11 sub 10, and so on. And again, we have to decide which way to parenthesize it. And the preferred way is from the bottom up. So 11 sub 10 is, that one means $10, and that one means one more dollar, so this is 11. So now we're going to do 12 sub 11 sub 10. Now, 11 sub 10, as we just saw, is 11. So what we have is 12 sub 11. 12 sub 11 is 11 plus 2, which is 13. So the sequence goes 10, 11, 13. Now we have to do 13 sub 12 sub 11 sub 10. Okay, 13 sub 13 by what we just did, and that's 13 plus 3 is 16. And that is obviously, by what we just did, 14 sub 16, which is 20. Now we will do one more. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. By what we know from the previous little calculation, it's 15 sub 20. But that one means $20, and add $5, so that's $25. Okay, so that's that's from the bottom up. Yeah. If we do it from the top down, we'll get a different sequence. This was pretty easy because we didn't have to recalculate everything each time. We could just use what we knew from the previous step. The difficulty with top down is that you have to redo the computation at each step. That's why the other one is preferred. All right, so 11 sub 10 is certainly 11. Now we have a 12 sub 11 sub 10. Now, 12 sub 11 is 13. So this is 13 sub 10. Which is 13. And you can see that it's the same so far. We are 10, 11, 13. All right. 13, 12, 11, 10 is equal to, parenthesized from the top down. 13 sub 12 is 12 plus 3 is 15. 15 sub 11 is 16. And then 16 sub 10 is 16, still the same as we had before. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Okay, 14, 13 is 17. 17, 12 is 19. 19 sub 11 is equal to 20. 20 sub 10 is 20. Holy cow!
Yeah.
All right, we'll go one more step.
Yeah. Breaking from the pack now.
Yeah, we've got a different sequence.
And this again, presumably the same thing will happen here?
Yes.
One
exactly the same. I have the same pictures as I showed you.
All right.
So now we've got four sequences. Parenthesized from the top down, from the bottom up. Yes. The question is, how big are these? Now, what happens if you go down a dungeon, n steps down towards the basement? How big is the number? If you have a number, you take its logarithm, it's much smaller than it. If you take the log of the log of the number, it gets really tiny. And if you take the log of the log of the log, it has to be a pretty big number before you get anything, there's anything that's left after you take logs. So with a tower of height n, you have to take logs n minus one times to bring it down to Earth. But these dungeons, they don't grow that fast, which is really surprising. What you get is that you only have to take logs twice before you get a number you can see.
But some of those numbers you showed me, like after you'd done hundreds of steps, were massive. Surely logging them twice wouldn't bring you down to a reasonable number.
Yes, it does. This is asymptotically. Yeah. 100 steps, we got a number that was that big, 10 to the 80. If we were taking logs to the base 10 of a number like 10 to the 80, 10 to the power 80, take logs, becomes 80 times log of 10. Call it 80. Take the log again, log of 80 is just under 2. So it drops down very quickly.
But I'm not surprised it has a different behavior because you're doing a completely different operation. With the towers, you were like multiplying numbers. But this operation you were doing with the dungeons involved like converting numbers into bases and things. So
yes.
It was a whole different game you were playing.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Brady. I was exaggerating a bit, yes. I mean, they do grow very quickly, and it is surprising when you work them out. You saw those how rapidly they grow, those numbers. See, initially we thought that they would grow just like towers, so it was really a surprise to find out that they don't. One really nice example. We've been talking about the notation a sub b, which means take the number a and read it as if it was written in base b. What if you took a and read it in base a, and read that in base a, and you went all the way to infinity? And in particular, I want to take a to be the number 1.1.
We'd like to thank Brilliant for supporting this video. Brilliant is a huge archive of puzzles, quizzes, courses, including the courses you're seeing on the screen at the moment. And these are just a selection of them. There are more all the time. Obviously, being a bit of a number file, the number theory one is one of my favorites. This is just a little tiny, tiny taste of what it looks like. If you're trying to get your body in shape, you're probably going to join a gym. You might even get a personal trainer if you're really serious about it. If you're trying to get your brain in shape, why not use Brilliant as your personal trainer with all these interactive puzzles and quizzes? It's fantastic. It's good fun and it makes you smarter. Go to brilliant.org/numberphile to have a look. And if you use the slash number file, they'll know you came from here and you'll get 20% off if you sign up to their premium subscription. That's the subscription that gives you access to everything. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode.
0.5 means 5 over 10. The 6 means 6 over 10 squared. If we take 1.1 sub itself forever,